Hello everyone. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about gear and gear drives, definition of gears, gear drives and types of gears, and advantages and disadvantages of gear drives over belt drives. In today's lecture, we will discuss about velocity ratio of gear drives, velocity ratio of simple gear train and some numerical problems. Now let us take a look into the definition of velocity ratio of gear drives. Velocity ratio of the gear drive is defined as ratio between the speed of the driver gear, which is also called as follower, and the speed of the driving gear, which is called as driver. And this velocity ratio is also called as speed ratio or transmission ratio of gear drives. In the figure you can see, this is the driven gear and this is the driving gear. This driving gear is also called as driver and this driven gear is also called as follower. So velocity ratio is defined as it is the ratio of speed of the driven gear, which is also called as follower, to the speed of the driving gear, which is also called as driver. And this velocity ratio is also called as speed ratio or transmission ratio. And this velocity ratio is given by N2 by N1 is equal to D1 by D2 and that is equal to T1 by T2, where this N1 is the speed of the driving gear, N2 is the speed of the driven gear, T1 is the number of teeth on the driving gear, T2 is the number of teeth on driven gear. D1 and D2 are the pitch circle diameter of driving and driven gear. Now let us take a look into the definition of gear train. Gear train consists of combination of two or more gears mounted on rotating shaft to transmit the power. Here we have different types of gear trains. First one is simple gear train and second one is compound gear train. For your syllabus, we have only the simple gear train and numericals on simple gear train. Let us take a look into the definition of simple gear train. Basically, this simple gear train is on each shaft, only one gear is mounted. In a simple gear train, on each shaft, only one gear is mounted. Whereas in compound gear train, there may be more than one gear on each shaft. In the below figure, you can see this is the example for the simple gear train. Simple gear train, on each shaft, only one gear is mounted. Here we have three gears and we have three shafts. On each shaft, there is only one gear. If there is more than one gear, then that mechanism is called as compound gear train. Now if you see the definition of simple gear train, simple gear train is an arrangement of gears in which each gear is mounted on its own shaft. Such an arrangement is used when it is required to transmit power between the driver and the driven shaft that are at large distance. So that is nothing but the simple gear train. And if you see the velocity ratio for simple gear train, if you see this arrangement, here we have four gears. This is one gear, second gear, third gear and fourth gear. The power has to be transmitted from this gear to this gear. So under that condition, this gear will be driver gear and this will be the driven gear. So these two are the intermediate gears, or they are also called as idler gears. These idler gears are not going to affect the velocity ratio of the gear drive. Instead, they will serve to fill the gap between the driver and the driven shaft or driven gear. And this intermediate gear also helps in achieving the desired direction of rotation for the driven shaft. So if you have four gears, here to calculate the velocity ratio or to find out the equation for the velocity ratio, we are going to consider only the driver and driven gear. These idler gears are used to give the support between the driver gear and the driven gear. So this will be gear 1, this will be gear 2, and this is gear 3, and this is gear 4. So under this condition, the velocity ratio of simple gear train is given by N4 by N1, that is equal to T1 by T4. So this kind of equations are used to solve the problem. And if you see the velocity ratio definition, velocity ratio for simple gear train is given by speed of last gear, that is driver gear, to the speed of first gear, that is driver gear, to the number of teeth on first gear, to the number of teeth on least gear or last gear. So that is the definition or velocity ratio for simple gear train. If you have three gears, so this arrangement is called as simple gear train, and here we have three gears. This is first gear, and this is second gear, and this is third gear. The power has to be transmitted from this shaft to this shaft. So here the velocity ratio for simple gear train is given by N3 by N1, that is equal to T1 by T3. Here it is N4 by N1 is equal to T1 by T4. So here we are going to, in the velocity ratio, we are going to consider only the driver gear and driven gear. If you have five gears, the first gear will be driver gear and the last gear will be driven gear. The first gear will be, the speed of the first gear is taken as N1, and the speed of the last gear is taken as N5, and T1 will be the number of teeth on the first gear, and T5 is the number of teeth on the driver gear. So under that condition, the velocity ratio for that mechanism or that simple gear train is given by N5 by N1 is equal to T1 by T5. So you have to make a note of it that the velocity ratio for simple gear train depends upon the number of gears, and here the intermediate gears or the idler gears are used to fill the gap between the driver gear and driven gear, or driver shaft to the driven shaft. So now let us take a look into the numerical problems on gear drives. The first problem is, the velocity ratio of gear drive is 2. Driving wheel has a 16 teeth and it turns on 120 revolution per minute. And he has told to find out the revolution per minute, that is the speed and the number of teeth on the driven wheel. So in this problem, he has given the velocity ratio, and here we have only two gears, that is driver gear and driven gear. So under that condition, the velocity ratio N1 by N2 is given, that is equal to 2. In the problem statement, he has mentioned the velocity ratio, and he has given the number of teeth on the driver gear, and he has given the speed of the driver gear. So we need to find out the teeth and speed of the driven gear. So when there are only two gears, if this rotates in clockwise direction, this will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. So this will be gear 1 and this will be gear 2. This is driver and this is driven. The speed of this gear is taken as N1 and the speed of this gear is taken as N2. And T1 is the number of teeth on driver gear and T2 is the number of teeth on the driven gear. So here we need to find out the number of teeth and speed of the driver gear. So we are going to use this equation. The ratio of N2 by N1 is given, that is 2. And the number of teeth on driver gear is given, it is 16. So when you solve, we are going to get the number of teeth on the driven gear. So that is 8. And to find out the speed of the driven gear, again we are going to use the same equation. So in this equation, we know ratio of N2 by N1 and we know T1 and T2. So the only unknown thing here is N2, and already we know the value for N1 and we know the value for T1 and T2. So when you solve this equation, we are going to get the speed of the driven gear, that is 240 rpm. So this was one problem which was having only two gears. Let us take a look into the second problem. I'll read the problem statement. A simple gear train consists of three gears. The number of teeth on the driving gear is 60. This is the driving gear. And on the idler, the number of teeth is 40. This is the idler gear. And on the driven gear, the number of teeth is 80. So if the driving gear rotates at 1200 rpm, so this is the driving gear, so that will become our N1. Find the speed of the driven gear, that is N2, and also the velocity ratio, and sketch the arrangement of the gear drive. So here we have three gears, and in that one gear is idler gear. So the idler gear will be always between the driving gear and the driven gear. So here you can see the sketch arrangement. And in this problem, he has told to find out the velocity ratio and as well as the speed of the driving gear. Here the velocity ratio means we need to find out N3 by N1. And we need to find out the value of N3. So here the equation what we are going to use is, so based on the number of gears, our equation will be N3 by N1 is equal to T1 by T3. And in this equation, we know N1, we know T1, and we know T3. So when you solve this equation, we are going to get the speed of the driven gear. And using the same equation, when we get the value of N3 and we know the value of N1, so the velocity ratio N1 by N3 is given by 3:4. Now let us take a look into the third problem. A simple gear train consists of four gears having a 30, 40, 50 and 60 teeth respectively. Determine the speed and the direction of the rotation of the last gear if the first gear makes 600 rpm in clockwise direction. So in this problem, he has told to find out the rotation of the last gear, that is gear 4. In this problem, he has mentioned there are four gears which is having, and the first gear is having 30 teeth, second is having 40 teeth, third gear is having 50 teeth, and last gear is having 60 teeth. So here in this problem, he has told to find out the speed of this driven gear, and he has told that the speed of this first gear is 600 rpm and it is rotating in clockwise direction. And when we draw the arrangement, here we have four gears. In the problem statement, he has mentioned that the first gear is rotating in clockwise direction. So when the first gear is rotating in clockwise direction, the second gear will be rotating in anti-clockwise direction, third gear will rotate in clockwise direction, and the last gear will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. The third gear will rotate in clockwise direction and the last gear will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. So here he has also told to find out the direction of the rotation of the last gear. So here the direction of the rotation of the last gear is in anti-clockwise direction. Here gear 2 and gear 3 are the intermediate gear or idler gear, which are not going to affect the velocity ratio of the given mechanism. Here in this problem, we are going to consider only the first gear and the last gear. Under that condition, our velocity ratio equation will be N4 by N1 is equal to T1 by T4. So this is the equation. In this equation, we know T1, we know T4, and N1 is given. So the only unknown is N4. When you solve this problem, we are going to get the speed of last gear, that is driven gear. It is 300 rpm and it is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. So these are the some simple problems which are solved with the help of velocity ratio equation. Thank you.